I want to help you write your introduction for your Paris Agreement essay. The first thing I want to talk to you about, though, is using sentence templates. So part of learning to write in college is learning how to use the ideas of others to inform your own. And doing this kind of source-based writing is called using your academic voice. So another way to put it is you're engaging in a conversation with others who are studying the same topic as you. In this case, you've been reading articles about what other folks are saying about the Paris Agreement, and then using that information to help you inform your own thinking and ideas. So a good way to learn the moves academic writers make to blend the ideas of others into their own writing is using sentence templates. So let me tell you a little bit about these sentence templates and where they came from. This book that you see on the screen, They Say, I Say, by Gerard Graff and Kathy Birkenstein, has revolutionized the way that college professors are teaching academic writing in college classes. So the reason why it's revolutionized the way students are learning to write their college-level essays is because it presents a series of templates for college writers to use to help them engage with the ideas of others in their writing. So I think the best way to figure out how to use these templates is to actually show you how to use them with this workshop. So we're going to try a couple of them to help you create your introduction to your Paris Agreement essay. All right? So, just a couple of reminders. Your introduction should generate interest in your topic by creating a hook. You should provide context for the issue by briefly explaining both sides of the Paris Agreement debate. And then you want to end with your thesis sentence. And in my opinion, I think this is actually the easiest part of your essay, because your thesis sentence is really the answer to this question: should the United States be part of the Paris Agreement? Your answer to that question is your thesis sentence. So let me get on a little bit with the creating a hook. So the first part of your introduction, of course, is going to be to create your hook. And for this essay, I'm going to refer you to a workshop that we used for our last essay. I show you a screenshot of what that handout looks like on the screen, and then I also posted it in our Blackboard class. But just to remind you, you might want to use any one of these strategies to create a hook that will pull the reader into your essay. So you could create an opening scene that connects to the Paris Agreement or climate change. You could start with a startling fact that you learned from one of your sources. You could profile a person that's connected to this topic or a group. You could provide relevant information on the topic, possibly about the Paris Agreement. Or you can open with a moment of dialogue if you're slightly even more creative. So after you have spent some time thinking about how you're going to pull the reader into your topic and you've created your hook, then you're ready to use one of these templates to help you create context. So for this essay, one of the ways you're going to be, or the way you're going to be creating context, is introducing the debate. So you want to make sure your readers know in your introduction what your topic is and a little bit about how people are feeling on both sides of the debate before you introduce your opinion on the debate. The reason why you do this is you want to make sure your readers understand that you have taken the time to look at multiple points of view on this topic. All right? So if you look at the screen here, you see a template. It looks like half sentences almost kind of strung together. But if you look at the template, it kind of steers your thinking in a way that a sentence template will. So if you look at the two examples that I provided for you in this unit, Catherine Roberts' essay and Larissa Tinkham's essay, when you look at those two introductions, you'll notice that they are using sentence templates to help them provide context for their paper. So let me just give you a quick example of how it would work. This template might work something like this. In recent discussions of climate change, most of us will agree that something needs to be done. Where this agreement usually ends, however, is on the question of the Paris Agreement. Some are convinced that the United States should be part of the Paris Agreement because of, and then you'd give your reasons why. Others are convinced that the United States should not be part of the Paris Agreement because, and you provide some forecasting reasons. And then here's your thesis sentence template. After viewing both sides of this debate, I believe the United States should or should not be part of the Paris Agreement. So you can see how what I would do with that template is kind of use the template to help me frame my own thinking or the direction of my paper. Let's look at another template. Here's another one you could try out. In the discussion of climate change, one controversial issue has been the Paris Agreement. On the one hand, some argue that, and then on the other hand, others contend that, and then you would fill in the blanks. My own view is that the United States should or should not be part of the Paris Agreement. So you can see how this kind of sentence template would help you write the context part of your introduction. So after you've created your hook, using one of the strategies that I talked about earlier, then you would use one of these two templates to help you frame your context, your explanation of this debate, and what's at stake. And then it will also provide your readers with your thesis sentence so they know what kind of argument they're going to be reading. Okay? So I want to give you a little bit of help with your thesis sentence. Once you have your hook and you have your context using one of the sentence templates, you would be ready to write your thesis sentence. And your thesis sentence for this essay literally answers this question: should the United States remain in the Paris Agreement? And either side of the debate is fine as long as your essay is going to be backing up with 3 to 4 concrete reasons why you have the opinion you have. Okay, so I hope, one more thing. I also wanted to give you a couple of templates that might help you create your conclusions as well. These templates also come from the same They Say, I Say book. And so ultimately what's at stake here is that sentence might launch you into a conclusion for your paper, or this one: this issue is important to anyone who cares about, and then you can kind of go from there. So the idea behind sentence templates is that they launch you into academic thinking and academic writing. And after a while, these templates become part of your toolbox that you use when you're writing essays for college. So I'm a big fan of this book. In fact, I've linked a copy of the entire book for you all inside of the Blackboard shelf this week. So I hope you get a chance to poke through the book. It's the entire book, so I'm not sure why it was for free, but it is for free online, and I provided it for you in our Blackboard class. I hope this workshop helps you, and I look forward